If I take a glass tumbler and put ice in it, around it we are having air. Air means mixture of dry air and superheated vapors. If I plot TS diagram, this is the line for the partial pressure of vapors. This is the constant pressure line, partial pressure of vapors. This is the dry bulb temperature. Vapors are superheated. Air is coming in contact with the periphery of the glass. Dry air is getting cooled. The superheated vapors are also getting cooled. The temperature for superheated vapors is decreasing. Here, the vapors become dry saturated. Further, since the temperature inside is very low, these dry saturated vapors, dry saturated steam, is losing heat. Now, when it loses heat, condensation of the steam takes place. So the temperature at which the condensation occurs and the first dew is formed, that is called as dew point temperatures. In a rough sense, you can say it is the temperature at which the moisture present in the air starts condensing. And the best statement is, it is the saturation temperature corresponding to the partial pressure of vapors. It is the saturation temperature corresponding to the partial pressure of vapors. Thus, we had three temperatures: dry bulb, wet bulb, and dew point. TD, TW, and TDP. When written in small, they are degree centigrade. When written capital, they are in Kelvin. The corresponding pressures corresponding to dry bulb temperature will be writing PS. the saturation pressure. Corresponding to wet bulb temperature, we'll be writing PSW. On psychrometric chart, this side was dry bulb temperature. So vertical lines horizontal, this is inclined lines. Wet bulb temperature. And then on this side, in some psychrometric charts, a scale is available, in some it is not available. And this is a scale for partial pressure of vapors. Supposingly in the question, this was the dry bulb temperature given, this was the wet bulb temperature given, they intersect at this condition. This is the condition of atmospheric air. From here, if you draw a horizontal line, this is the partial pressure of vapors. We can read knowing dry bulb and wet bulb temperatures. In many charts it is not available, and supposingly we are required to calculate. The equation is PV is equal to PSW minus PB minus PSW into TD minus TW upon 1527.4 minus 1.3 TW. Two, three empirical equations are available in the literature. Most commonly used is this equation. So all the terms already I have explained. I have to calculate the dew point temperature. This dry bulb and wet bulb given, this is PV, and PV shall become saturated when it meets the saturation line. So this temperature is the saturation temperature corresponding to the partial pressure of vapors. That means from the given point, when you draw a horizontal line, wherever it meets the saturation line, that temperature shall be called as dew point temperature. Or from this equation, get PV, from the steam table, get saturation temperature against PV, that shall be the dew point temperature. जब आप दिमाग लगाओ ना, इतने प्रेशर्स लिखे हुए हैं, PB किस चीज के लिए प्रेशर यूज होता है? PB इज द बैरोमेट्रिक प्रेशर. Next term, specific humidity, denoted by W. This is defined as the amount in kg of vapors present in the air per kg of dry air. When pressures are quite small, PV of the order of 0.02, the vapors are assumed to behave like a gas. For vapors, PV VV is equal to MV, RV and TV. For dry air, PA VA is equal to MA, RA, TA. This symbol A is used for dry air. When we divide the two, as per Dalton's law, each constituent is to occupy the same volume. Vapors and dry air have to occupy the same volume. Dry air, vapors, they are at the same temperatures. mv upon ma, kg of vapors per kg of dry air. This becomes a specific humidity. This is equal to PV upon PA into RA upon RV. इस साइड में पीछे जो बैठे हुए हैं आपके पड़ोसी ब्लू शर्ट वाले, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ आर फॉर वेपर्स एंड फॉर ड्राई एयर? ये पी वी इज इक्वल टू एम आर टी नाइन्थ क्लास से पढ़ना शुरू कर देते हैं. पढ़ाई खत्म हो जाती है तब भी इस इक्वेशन का पता नहीं चलता. आप लोग बीटेक पास कर आए हो, पीवी इज इक्वल टू एम आर टी अभी भी नहीं पता. The value of R for any gas is universal gas constant divided by the molecular mass. If I have to calculate for dry air, universal gas constant is 8.4813. And molecular mass of dry air is 28.966. If you divide the two, you will get 0.287. ये 0.287 तो सबको याद रहता है, कहाँ से आया ये नहीं याद रहता. अगर ये याद रहता हो तो जब R फॉर वेपर्स निकालें तो 8.4813, वेपर्स मीन्स H2O मीन्स 18. और ए 0.287 अपॉन 0.4712 पीवी अपॉन पीए. Dry air never exists. PB, the barometric pressure, is that of dry air plus vapors. So for dry air, it is PB minus PV. सबसे पीछे वाले के साथ वाले, हाँ आप बताइए, व्हाट शुड बी द यूनिट फॉर W? कुछ नहीं, डायमेंशन नहीं है, यूनिट्स हैं, क्योंकि ऊपर के केजी वेपर्स के हैं, नीचे केजी ड्राई एयर के हैं, तो वेपर्स के केजी और ड्राई एयर के केजी आपस में कटते नहीं हैं। This side was the driver temperature, and this side, if you see, it is specific humidity. And along with it, it is written kg of vapors per kg of dry air. If dry bulb temperature is given, wet bulb temperature is given, where they intersect, from there if you draw a horizontal line on the right hand side, you will be able to read the value, which is given in kg of vapors per kg of dry air. Next, it is degree of saturation or percentage saturation, and is denoted by the symbol mu. And is defined as the amount of vapors present in the given mass of air and at a given dry bulb temperature, and the amount of vapors required to saturate the same mass of air and at the same dry bulb temperature. Whatever I have written in the numerator and denominator, same I repeat and divide by kg of dry air. Dry air is considered as datum, so most of the things we will be writing on the basis of dry air. Read very carefully the numerator and denominator. This is how this specific humidity was defined. This shall be the specific humidity when the air becomes saturated. Kg of vapors per kg of dry air. Kg of vapors at saturation per kg of dry air. 0.622 PV upon PV minus PV. 0.622 PS upon PV minus PS. When the air shall become saturated, partial pressure of vapor shall be written as saturation pressure. If I ask you, how much is the mass of air present in this room. How do you guess? If I ask you, how much is the volume of air in this room? Which one is simple to guess? Mass or volume? Getting the concept of volume is very simple, knowing the dimensions. Getting the concept of mass, after volume, I should know the density of the air. And density of the air throughout the day keeps on changing. So, getting the concept of volume is simpler rather than getting the concept of mass. And hence, this term has become obsolete and these days is not used. Only in the books, as an academic interest, still we keep on using it. Instead, we use the term relative humidity, written as RH or phi. Kg of vapors present in the given volume of air at a given dry bulb temperature. And the kg of vapors at saturation in the same volume of air at the same given temperature. Everything is same except whatever was mass here. Here I have written in terms of volume. Agar main kehta hoon ki relative humidity room mein 40% hai. This will mean the moisture present is 40% of that what maximum it could have. Maximum it could have means when the air had become saturated. for vapors, PV, VV is equal to MV, RV and TV. And if we divide the two, same volume for ordinary vapors or saturated vapors. Same temperature, same value of R, because both the values are for steam. And what is MV upon MS? It is the relative humidity. In this room, some vapors were present. I put it as a cooler. I keep on adding more vapors. Earlier, the partial pressure of vapors was PV. More vapors are being added. Their partial pressure will also tend to increase. And when air shall become saturated, PV shall become PS and the relative humidity shall become 100%. This was degree of saturation. Here also the term PV upon PS is there. That means mathematically we can develop a relationship, and that shall mean PV upon PS into 1 minus PS upon PB upon one minus PV upon PB. In the denominator, I can multiply and divide by PS. The advantage will be one term shall be PV upon PS, which is already existing. Other term is PS upon PB, which is there in the numerator also. And PV upon PS we have defined as the relative humidity. Thus, mu becomes phi into 1 minus PS upon PB upon 1 minus phi PS upon PB. If I cross multiply mu minus mu phi PS upon PB is equal to phi into 1 minus PS upon PB. Mu is equal to phi into 1 minus PS upon PB. This term shall become plus phi is out plus mu PS upon PB. And this may be written as phi into 1 minus mu PS upon PB. Thus, phi becomes mu upon 1 minus mu upon PS upon PB.